Gustavo Wall has been spreading his brand of legislative theater and social justice through theater, theater in the community, interactive theater. This is a man who has survived torture and has been exiled, has come back from the other side with an enormous sense of humor and an enormous sense of gratitude. Please put your hands together in helping me welcome Dr. Gustavo Wall.
Torture, and I also survived last year 3 arthroscopies in my knee, which was almost as painful as the torture. I have 2 great difficulties to start to talk in public. I have 2 great difficulties. It's very hard for me to talk in public. The first great difficulty is how to start. I never know how to start talking. And the other one, the worst difficulty is how to stop talking. And today it's going to be a problem because we have very, very short time. If we arrive at doing a legislative demonstration, all of you deserve a medal that's going to wait for you outside. When you go out, claim for your medal, I participated in 1 hour legislative theater. Normally, legislative theater is very long. Can I ask you something? Because I said something that I did not explain well. I wanted a corridor here, but a small one. And now I see here, I look like a ventilator here. Look both sides. Can you move a little bit inside? Leave only a small space here. Bring your chair, bring your chairs. And you too. But do it fast because today we have high velocity. Leave a small space. Leave a small space. Photographers also, leave a small space. Okay? That's enough. Look. Said no. But you can listen.
You are close to me. You back there. Do you listen? Hear me or not?
No.
Okay. So, accept. Democracy. What is the legislative theater? We do theater of the oppressed, which is the larger thing. Theater of the oppressed is many things. It's the rainbow of desire, the internal techniques, to theatricalize the mental problem that we may have. We have the invisible theater, we have the direct actions, we have lots of newspaper theater, and we have the legislative theater. The legislative theater is what? Is to try to change the law, to make a new law or modify existing laws or ban certain laws. So our objective as Theater of the Oppressed is a little bit different from Shakespeare. Shakespeare used to say that, he said that in Hamlet, that the theater is a mirror. And this mirror shows us our vices and our virtues. And it's okay. It's a very beautiful definition. But what I want is a mirror, yes, but a magic mirror in which you can penetrate inside it. And if you don't like your image, you go there and you change your image. We want a theater, a democratic theater, in which this space here can be democratically divided with you. You create the force of this stage, so you have the right to come here. Then we want to transform. In the present, we want to analyze the past, to invent the future, and not to wait for the future. We have to create our future. No? And then this we can say, yes, but if I go on stage, I do my desire, I act my desire. Yeah, that's okay, that's beautiful, but that's a fiction. And I say, yes, it is a fiction. It is a fiction, but you do it. And the act of transforming transforms he or she who acts. This is very important to know. The other day I was talking with the people from my groups. We have several different groups. We have a group of housemates. And then I asked all of them to write poems. And one of them said, no, I cannot write a poem because I'm not a poet. And I said, don't think like that. You don't have to be a poet to write a poem. But whoever writes a poem becomes a poet. It is by doing that you become. You are your acts. You are your actions. If I do transform the clay into a statue, I become a sculpture. And then this is important for us. Well, theater of press is a way of allowing people to try to do things that they have been told that they are not able to, because they are not poets, because they are not legislators, because they are not teachers, because they are not what, but they are capable of doing it. So come and do it, and by doing it you become. You become by action, and not only by desire, mere desire. What we want is democracy in last resort. But democracy is one of those words that have many different meanings. No, you can call democracy anything. No, we know that all words in general, they are means of transportation. They transport, they can be beautiful, and they transport the meaning. The meaning is important, but the word itself, it can transport contradictory meanings. And then we have to see what democracy we want, really. Sometimes we say that, well, Greece was the cradle of democracy, but in Greece, women did not vote. If women did not vote, half of the population did not vote. The foreigners did not vote. The slaves did not vote. So it was a very particular democracy in which very few people could vote. So this democracy is not a democracy, a real democracy. In many countries also, to be president of the republic, you have to buy your time on television, you have to buy your time, in your space in the newspaper. And if you have to buy, you have to have the money. And who has the money to spend all those millions and millions and millions of dollars in so many countries? Those who are rich. So this is not democracy if only the rich can be president of the republic. So what kind of democracy we want? We have thought about the direct democracy. Direct democracy was that the people would vote, everyone would vote. But that's not possible. We cannot put together the population of a city, the population of a state, and ask them, all of them, to have free will, free speech, and talk and then vote. It's not possible. So we have a representative democracy. And of course, we have good representative people that are going to fulfill their promises. But we know that in many countries, that's not the rule. The rule is that they promise something, you vote for their promise, and then their deeds are not exactly what the promises made us believe. So the representative democracy is also complicated, but there are now others. So we are trying what can we really try to do something to make more effective democracy? And then in Brazil we started with the participatory budget. So the Workers' Party created the idea of the participatory budget, in which the population concerned by the budget gets together and discusses the budget in theater before they discuss how much money goes here and there. For instance, if you have $1 million to spend on health, then we get together all the doctors, the patients, the families of the patients, the neighbors of the hospital, the functionary, everyone, they come to an assembly, and then you present a play of foreign theater in which the spectator goes on stage. And then after discussing concretely, then they vote how much money goes this, how much money goes that. It's a form of direct, indirect democracy, but it's a form in which you can interfere and not want to expect the next elections. Because the person, the citizen, has an extraordinary power, the power of the vote. But it's a paradoxical power, because you, in the moment that you exert that power, you lose it. And then you are going to recover it 4 years later. So we started by working with participatory budget, and then we said, we can talk about any other law, not only about budget only. And then we started doing what we call legislative theater, which is something very simple. We do normally a play that is short, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. We are going to present here two plays. they don't have more than 7 minutes, each one of them, that presents a problem that they don't know how to solve. Something that concerns the population, concerns the group that presents the play. In our case, it's not a play that we have written because they have been working only 3 days. So they have the clothes that they had at home, they don't have settings, and the text itself is not memorized, it's not written really. No, so it's more or less improvised, but more or less with the right ideas, if not always with the same words, but with the right ideas. We present the play. We present the play, and then we invite you to observe the play and observe that there is a protagonist who has a desire to do something, but does not know how to solve the problem that he's confronted with. So the play ends, and then I ask you if you agree that this problem that was presented here, if it is really a problem, if it is reality, or it's just the fantasy of someone. We expect that you are going to say, yes, this is a problem. Okay, we don't know the solution. And instead of doing the political theater of the 50s, that I myself did do, I'm not accusing the other ones and say they did bad things and I did a good one. No, because I did also the pamphlet, the agitprop, that comes with that, and I said, you have to do this, you have to do that. Instead of telling imperative what you have to do, which is something that we are so much used to listen to, do this, do that. If you look at television, you get crazy because all of the time there are imperative orders, do this, do this. And what we want is the opposite, to dynamize people. I would even say that when some people ask me, but what is dynamizing? What means dynamize? I mean, explain. Dynamize is the exact opposite of watch TV. Watch TV. If you ask, the person who looks at TV, watch TV, does not see the other person at his side who is looking also at TV. You can be all in the same room, but everyone is isolated. Everyone is receiving from the television. I have some hate against television because television tries really to make us robot of ourselves. No, makes the prothesis of desire and inoculates the desire of the market inside ourselves. So it's the opposite of what dynamizing is, and we want to dynamize. And then, well, we ask you, you have any solution, any idea, any alternative to this problem? Of course there are alternatives. If you, all of you think about how to solve a problem, I am sure that many good ideas are coming out of you. If you will present a play here and say, that's the way reality is, then we are putting down through your throat our vision of the world. But we don't want that. We want you to come here and say, I believe that the solution is this, or the solution is that, the best alternative. And then we try, we improvise together with you, and then at the end, we have 3, 4, 5 interventions. In the legislative theater, this is a forum theater. The legislative theater is the same thing up to here. And then you say, okay, we have to go and transform reality. So to transform reality, let's try to make a project of law. All of you received paper and pencil, no? Or something, something to write. So you look and say, if there were a law more or less like this, this could help the protagonist in this case. Because sometimes you fight, and you can win or lose, but sometimes you fight, and if the law is against you, you cannot win. There is no chance of winning if the law is against you. In many countries, like in my country, for instance, there are some laws that catch and laws that don't catch. It's not enough to have a law to be obeyed. The people don't like that law, we forget about that law, and it goes on being a law. So, but even so, if it's a law that's not going to be used, it's important to have the law on our side. So you write what kind of law would you like to have to solve this kind of problem. Then two people are going to collect all those informations, all those propositions or projects of law. We are going to give to them or to one of them, because one of them has to leave before perhaps. And they are asking them, look, this here is possible. Many people come and say, okay, the solution is a law that says everyone should be happy. Okay, it's nice, everyone to be happy. But you cannot put a law like that. So you have to make a law, you have to have some elements. Then we ask them, which of those can be voted, no? And then we put in votation with you. We say, first law that's proposed, first project of law. We read the project of law. And then if someone wants to talk against, come here and talks against. But if someone talks against, someone has to talk in favor. So we have a contradictory debate. And then we open the votation for the audience, and then we have the vote. And then we say, we proclaim this law. Of course, it has no legal value. But then starts another part of the process, which is the pressure that we have to exert on the chambers to approve that law. In Brazil, when I was lawmaker, I was inside the Chamber of Rio, then we approved the 13 laws. Some were not so important. All of them were very important, but not for the whole population. For instance, to have a kindergarten in all schools that belong to the city, or to have places for elder people in the hospitals. So it was for elder people, it was for teachers of the school, and the students, and the functionaries. It was, but the first Brazilian law to protect witness of crime, which is something very important in Brazil, because many people don't want to be witness because they are afraid of what can happen to them. And before our law, you have to go, if you are a witness, you have to go to the police and give your name, your address, your telephone number and everything, and the lawyer of the criminal can go there and know where you live and all that. Now we made a law, a very complex law, and it was the first Brazilian law that became a state law, and now for our pride, it is a national law, much bigger than the original one, because the original one was only the city, and then it became now a national law. So it can have results if you make pressure. It's not enough, it's auto self-satisfaction that we have done a very beautiful law, now you tear it up and it's over. Then if we do it, let's make pressure. That's the moment in which the population organize, the population can obtain things. Sometimes people say, oh, Brazilian government is not left enough. It's not the government that has to be left. It is the people that have to be left and make pressure on the government, and then the government can change. If we don't make any pressure on nobody, nothing is going to happen. It's going to go, and we are watchers, we are observers, we are spectators. And in the theater of the press, we have abolished the word spectator. We have spectator. Spectator is the one who spects, in Latin, the one who sees, who looks at, and later who acts out. Is that clear what I'm telling you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't feel enthusiasm. Did you? No, I don't want bravo to me. I want the idea. The idea had to be Bobby Lachlan, not me.
Bravo to the idea!
Bravo to the idea. Okay, so what I'm going to propose is this. Julian, where is Julian? Julian is going to tell you, because it's talk about act, spectacular, about you go and you do it. And you are sitting there, like in all kinds of theater. You are sitting there wanting to consume. So we don't want you to consume. So we want you to do something to start with. Usually we do 3, 4, 5 games, exercises with the whole audience. As we really don't have much time, we are going to do only one. So you try to do it the best that you can do, because it's the only chance that you are going to have. Julian, you are going to tell them what is the take the microphone.
Okay. Can I have 2 volunteers?
That are good in rhythm. Are you good in rhythm? Are you good in rhythm? You are?
Good enough.
Okay. Thank you.
to be like this. The beginning, all of you are going to be in pair like they are, and they are going to make. You're going to say one, you say two, you say three, then one again, two, three, one, two, three, and it's okay. Okay?
Okay?
One, two, three, one, two, three.
One.
Two.
Three.
One.
Two.
Three.
One.
Two.
Three.
One.
Two.
Perfect. But there will be a moment in which I will say, exchange number one. And then instead of saying number one, what you're going to do is to make a physical gesture plus a sound. And you will not say no longer number one. You're going to say, instead of number one, let's suppose that you're going to slick ta. Okay, and then two, three, and then slick ta. You will have to repeat the gesture and the sound that you done. Okay, and then I will say change number two, and then I will say change number three. So let's start. One, two, three, one, two, three.
One.
Two.
Three.
One.
Two.
Three.
One.
Two.
Three.
Exchange number one. Oops.
Three.
Oops.
Two.
Three.
Oops.
Two.
Three.
Oops.
Change. No, no, go ahead. Sorry.
Three.
Four.
Two.
Three.
Oops.
Change number two.
Whoa.
Three.
School. We have two plays. Come, the school group. Come, the school group. Come on, come on. They are going to present a very short scene. All the scenes, they can be a whole play. I have done in Paris, this is the group that I had in Paris when I lived there. I have done a Greek tragedy, Iphigenia in Aulis, a Greek tragedy entire. And then we made the forum on the text. You know? In Norway, they have done with The Enemy of the People by Ibsen, the whole play, five acts play. And then you choose a part to make a forum. So it could be a play with more details, with more information, so that you could intervene with more knowledge of the problem. In this case, it's just one scene that lasts 5 minutes, more or less. So it's not the complexity of the problem, but shows only the small problem, okay? Now then, we do first display. Are you ready?
Yes.
Go!
You're absolutely right.
Wait. We're going to make sure that we make some time for that as well. I'm going to add it to the list of our topics.
Ms. Rogers, yes. Wait a minute. I'm really concerned about my grade point average. I have to do really well on this test or I won't get into college. I don't want to study this stuff.
Absolutely.
Can we just
Absolutely.
Focus on what's on the test?
It's very important. Really, all of you, it's very important that you do well on the test.
No,
but I believe in you. We're working on this. You're going to get this. We're going to do the work you need for the test and to do well. And we'll take some time and go more into depth into the other topics.
But Ms. Rogers, those tests, they're irrelevant.
Yeah.
They're hurting our education.
Yeah.
You know, I think, I mean, don't you believe in what Martin Luther King did and his actions and his ideals and getting involved?
Yeah.
I do. I do.
Fired.
Hey there.
Okay. That's the scene.